Welcome to LMS Solution. So today we are going to see about MPPT solar charger controller in MATLAB simulation. In MPPT solar charger controller consists of these different elements. So one is solar PV array, DC to buck converter, and then battery, and MPPT control, and battery charging control, and then building generator. So the MPPT used for extract the maximum power from the solar PV array. So this battery charger can be used for charge the battery based upon two conditions. So one is SOC, state of charge, and then based upon voltage level. So COV nothing but cell wall voltage, FCV nothing but float cell voltage. Okay, so you have to maintain the voltage in between these two conditions, and the battery voltage is equal to FCV means the SOC normally is equal to 0%. If COV is near, that when battery voltage is nearer to the COV, then the SOC comes to 100%. So based upon these two parameter, SOC and the battery voltage, say we have to control the buck converter in order to charge the battery with the maximum power point algorithm concept. So here in MPPT algorithm we have to measure the PV current and PV voltage. So based upon that parameter PV voltage and current, so when we generate the duty cycle. So in battery charger controller, so based upon SOC and battery voltage, if that SOC is less than 100% and the floating voltage, sorry, battery voltage in between the float voltage or the over voltage condition, then it will be allow the duty cycle in order to generate the pulse for that buck converter. If suppose SOC is equal to 100% and VPV equal to COV, then it will be stop the duty cycle. For that means this does not allow the duty cycle to generate the pulse for the buck converter. So this is a basic operation of the MPPT solar charger controller. So how we can implement that MPPT solar charger controller in MATLAB? So let's we go to that MATLAB simulation. So this is a implemented diagram of that MPPT solar charger controller. Here I am going to use 200 watts PV panel. Just going to click this panel detail. Okay, here I am going to use two parallel string and then four series sticks. Okay, so this is a 1 PV array details. So maximum power will be maximum power is 250 watts. Then maximum voltage is 30.9 and maximum current. Then current at maximum power point and voltage at maximum power point condition. Okay. So series model is full, right? That means you have to multiply this voltage, that means voltage by 4. So with 30.9, I think you will get around the 30.9 into 4, so 123.6 volt. Okay, so the panel voltage at the terminal at particular maximum power point condition is 123.6 volt, and then you consider putting two parallel string, right? Two, then you want to multiply with current, so 8.1 into 2, so 8.1 into 2, So 16.2. So current at maximum power point. In a standard test condition, the current will be 16.2. So power of that PV panel at maximum power point at that standard condition is 123.6 into 16.2. So around 2000 watts. Okay. So rating of that panel is 2000 watts. It consists of two parallel string and four series strings. Okay. So and then so these are the input for the solar PV panel. That means irradiation and temperature. So this is DC-DC buck converter. So used to for charge the battery. And then this is P and dual MPPT plus battery charger controller. This will go inside that block. So this block consists of two things. One is P and dual algorithm, and then battery charger controller. So in P and dual algorithm, so you have to measure the PV panel details. That means voltage of the PV panel, current of the PV panel. So from that you have to calculate power of the PV panel. So after that you have to calculate the change in power from current instant to previous instant. So just I'm going to delete that power by some relay block, and then I'm going to find out the change in power. And same way you have to find out the change in voltage from current instant to previous instant by using the relay block. So I'm going to measure the change in voltage. So next I'm going to check the change in voltage. First you need to check the change in voltage condition, whether it is greater than or equal to 0 or less than or equal to 0. Okay. For example, you consider this one, right? If is greater than threshold. So threshold is 0. If change in voltage is greater than 0, okay, then it will allow this small change into the cycle. Okay. If this condition is false, then it will allow this. Okay. If this condition is true, it will allow that means when we decrease the duty cycle by this amount. If this condition is false, it going to increase the duty cycle by this amount. And same way we can check this same condition also and vice versa. Okay. If threshold voltage is greater than 0, then you get to increment this duty cycle by this amount. Otherwise you can decrement the duty cycle by this amount. Okay. So this output of that this block will be connected to this. Here I'm going to, we are going to check that power level. That means change in power is greater than or equal to 0. If change in power is greater than 0, you have to allow this condition. If power is less than 0, then allow this condition. Okay. And then this output, the output of this block will be added. That means it will be added with the previous duty cycle. And then yes, duty cycle is given to that battery charger controller. So next in battery charger controller, already told that you have to check two condition. So one is you need to check the SOC, another one is you need to check the battery voltage level. Here we have to check the battery voltage level. That means you have to compare with that cell over voltage condition. So just to go to measure the battery parameter. So this is the SOC, this one is current of that battery, charging current, ultra charging current. So this one is voltage of that battery. Here I am going to compare the SOC with the ultra percentage, whether it is less than or equal to 0. And also I am going to compare that battery voltage is less than or equal to cell over voltage. If both condition is true, okay, then it going to allow that the 2D cycle to the petroleum generator, not to generate the pulse for that DC to DC power converter to charge the battery. Okay, and also it has another block, that means this is used for finding the efficiency of the battery charger. Okay, here this is the power of the battery. So this is the power from that solar. So just you have to take output divided by input, and then you have to multiply with 100% and it will provide the charging efficiency of that charger control. Okay, so this is the implementation of MPPT PN algorithm and battery charger controller for battery charging application. So next you have to simulate this Simulink model. Here I set that condition, solar radiation is 1000 watts per meter square and cell temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, so for that condition you can see that the output power from the solar PV is around 1850 watts from the solar PV, and then you can see that this is SOC of that battery, so this is charging rate of that battery, so this is the battery voltage of that battery. So you can see that voltage level of the battery going to be increases because of charging current from the DC DC buck converter. So now you have to check that efficiency of that battery charger controller is around 97.98%. Okay, next I'm going to change the irradiation level to find it. And I am going to change that irradiation to 500, so power extraction is around 980 watts, and then you can see that charging current going to be decreases because of change in irradiation condition, but it's still charging that battery. Okay, so you can see that there was some improvement in that SOC. It changed from 50 to 50.01. next you have to check the efficiency of the system. So efficiency of the system is around 90.2. okay, so that's all about MPPT solar charger controller model. Thank you. So I have started a new online course relevant to that solar PV system. So for that, just you have to go to this website itps.net. okay, and then go to this link, that means online course. Just you have to click this online course, so you are going to navigate to another page. So we created one online course related to MATLAB modeling of solar PV system. So this online course discuss about modeling of solar PV cell, solar PV array, and then IGBT characteristics of the solar PV array, how to implement the MPPT algorithm for solar PV system, and implementation of MPPT solar charger controller, and then how that solar system is integrated with the grid. So this details is going to be discussed in the online course. And also we provided a MATLAB Simulink model relevant to that this course, modeling of solar PV array, MPPT control of solar PV array, MPPT charger controller, and grid connected solar PV system. So you have to access that online course, just you have to click this link. So it asks about some sign up, just you have to use your Gmail account to sign up. after signing that this web page. Just want to click the link. So you see that link course details, and then videos relevant to that online course. So how to use that MATLAB model, how to that mean different things, so operation of that solar PV system, and also it consists of a MATLAB file. Just you have to click this one, you can download that MATLAB file relevant to that solar PV systems. Okay, thank you.